Thank you. rest, the true north, strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land, glorious and free. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee.
The University of Guelph would like to acknowledge the Attawandaron people on whose traditional territory the University of Guelph resides, and offer respect to our Haudenosaunee, Anishinaabe, and Métis neighbors as we strengthen our relationships with them. Today is a day of recognizing new beginnings, new opportunities, new relationships, perhaps new ways of doing things, new insights, new directions, new faces, all in the midst of the old. Some are excited about new things, some are hesitant about anything new. Most of us have a mixture of both of those. I came across this quote: with every new breath we take, there's a new chance and a new door opened for us, and a new dawn declaring a new start of something amazing. That's a lot of new things. But scientists tell us that in reality, there are no such things as new breaths. When we breathe in, the breath contains molecules and atoms that have been around for centuries, eons even, and that every new thing is made up of old things. The old breath that I expel out is in some part the new breath that you take in. So it is with new ideas and new people. They are not all entirely new, but part of something that has been around for a long time. Take President and Vice Chancellor Frank Vaccarino, for example. I've had some brief opportunities to chat with him. Yes, he is new, but he is also old. Not in his age, but old in the way of being comfortable. People are comfortable around him. There is something familiar about him. And that something familiar is the human bond we all enjoy. That same bond that connects us to each other and to the cosmos around us. It is to all that we hold sacred that we give thanks today for both the old and the new. And we do so in a spirit of love and compassion that holds us fast. Amen.
Please be seated. Mr. Chancellor, members of the Board of Governors, members of the Board of Trustees, honorary fellows, honorary degree recipients, executive members of the University of Guelph, ministers of the Crown and their representatives, past presidents, William Weingard and Alistair Summerlee, presidents of colleges and universities from across Canada and their representatives, Mr. Akhilesh Mishra, Consul General of India, representatives of the Association of Universities and Colleges of Canada and the Council of Ontario Universities, faculty, staff, and students, honored guests, Vaccarino family and friends, welcome to the installation of the University of Guelph's 8th President and Vice Chancellor. Mr. Chancellor, I have the honor to present to you Franco J. Vaccarino. Mr. Chancellor, on behalf of the Board of Governors of this university, I ask you to install Franco J. Vaccarino as the President and Vice Chancellor of the University of Guelph.
Do you, Franco J. Vaccarino, pledge yourself to perform the duties of the President of the University of Guelph as prescribed by law and by the statutes of the university, and do you promise to defend the rules and to promote the welfare of the university and the members thereof?
I do.
In the name of the university, now, I have to help with your robe, I believe. So if we can just help. In the name of the University of Guelph, I now install you, Franco J. Vaccarino, in the office of President and Vice Chancellor of the University of Guelph, and I invest you with the authority and charge you with the responsibilities pertaining to that office. Congratulations.
President Vaccarino, as a member of the senior administration, I'm very pleased to bring greetings on behalf of the University of Guelph. Greetings and congratulations. Congratulations on your official installation. And we welcome you as our 8th President and Vice Chancellor of the University of Guelph. We look forward to the impact your knowledge and experience will bring in organizational leadership, as an educator, internationally recognized researcher, scholar, and accomplished administrator. Your strong sense of community, commitment to societal engagement, and learner-centeredness will further develop and promote the University of Guelph as an international leader. As we celebrate the milestone of 50 years, we look forward to developing a vision and pathway that will position the University of Guelph as a global leader in academic excellence. Now, I am honored to read formal greetings from the Prime Minister of Canada, Stephen Harper, on behalf of Michael Chong, Member of Parliament for Wellington Halton Hills. And this is from Stephen Harper. I am pleased to extend my warmest greetings and congratulations to Dr. Franco J. Vaccarino on his official installation as the 8th President and Vice Chancellor of the University of Guelph. I would also like to bid a warm welcome to distinguished guests and faculty in attendance for this ceremony. Dr. Vaccarino's appointment to the office of President and Vice Chancellor is a testament to the trust and confidence the Board of Governors places in his abilities. Since it was founded in 1964, the University of Guelph has been committed to bringing out the best in every student. I am certain that the wealth of teaching and administrative experience Dr. Vaccarino brings to the job will prove invaluable as the University of Guelph continues to build upon its reputation of excellence in teaching, research, and administration. Please accept my best wishes for a memorable investiture ceremony and for every future success. Signed, Stephen Harper. President Vaccarino, we also have a number of well-wishers with us today who would like to provide special greetings to you as well. First, I am pleased to introduce you to a long-standing friend of the university, Minister of Education and MPP Guelph, the Honorable Liz Sandals.
Thank you, John, and it's a pleasure to join all of you here today and bring you warm greetings and congratulations from the Government of Ontario. Particularly, congratulations from my colleague, Reza Maridi, Minister of Training, Colleges and Universities. And I did, in fact, discover, Franco, that you have a caucus fan club. I bet you didn't know that. I also bring greetings from the Honorable Brad Duguid, who worked with you very closely at Scarborough, and from our caucus chair, Lala Albanese, who is very much wanted to be here but couldn't, but is an old friend, I think, of Franco. So I bring you greetings from a number of people that you've known in the past. We're delighted to welcome Dr. Franco Vaccarini as the university's new president. Dr. Vaccarino is not only a brilliant scholar, educator, and administrator, but also a gifted researcher and leader who has helped advance academic research agendas at the provincial, national, and international levels. His interdisciplinary research accomplishments in the areas of neuroscience, addiction, and mood and anxiety system have been recognized internationally, including by the World Health Organization. And he is a respected speaker, mentor, and board member of many organizations and advisory councils. But I'm not here to read you the long version of his very impressive CV and his past accomplishments. I'm here to talk about the present and the future of this wonderful university. As you can appreciate, the president of a university plays a crucial role. The president must take to heart the life of the university, the day-to-day experience of its students, staff, and stakeholders. And he or she must help ensure the university continues to nurture global citizens, engaged alumni, motivated collaborators, and a strong voice in the community. I would like to applaud this university. The University of Guelph is a great partner in helping to build the highly skilled workforce Ontario needs to compete globally. Guelph is recognized annually as one of Canada's top comprehensive universities, not only by various external organizations, but most importantly by its own students. They see the university as a center of excellence, particularly in agri-science and rural development, through its key partnership with the Ministry of Agriculture, Food and Rural Affairs. But I must say, we dealt with that this morning when we were celebrating OVC's newest incoming class. But from a totally parochial point of view, as a graduate of the College of Physical Science, and my father, as you know, was the first dean of physical science, I must commend to you the College of Physical and Engineering Science for very special affection. 2014 marks an auspicious anniversary for the university. Its 50th year, building on course on a much longer heritage from the three founding colleges. In that time, the university has had a huge impact locally, regionally, and internationally. In the city of Guelph, the university has had a tremendous influence on not only its economy through jobs, business spin-offs, research and commercialization, but also in its culture through the arts and a legacy of great graduates. Dr. Vaccarino, I think you will find that the city and the university share a characteristic. Both have grown in population and sophistication, but both retain their small town sense of friendliness and caring. It's why Guelph natives and Guelph grads all keep coming back to Guelph. So I think you will find that we have a very unique and friendly culture here. Globally, the University of Guelph continues to bring much to the world, and I look forward to seeing what our next 50 years will bring. But in the meantime, welcome Dr. Vaccarino to our university community, to this five-star university with a heart. Thank you.
Thank you, Liz. And now on behalf of the university, I'm happy to welcome Anne Papert, who will deliver messages on behalf of the City of Guelph. Anne?
Good afternoon. I'm very pleased to be here to offer greetings on behalf of the City of Guelph. We are delighted to welcome President Vaccarino to our community. From its earliest beginnings, the University of Guelph has played a tremendous leadership role in shaping the broader community of Guelph, and that positive influence continues today. As the university has grown and flourished, so has the city. The university's world-class research and innovation has certainly put Guelph on the map in Canada and across the world. The university's contributions to arts, heritage, culture, and volunteerism has played a vital part in our character and our identity. And together, the faculty, the staff, the students, and the alumni make a difference here. And that is greatly respected and appreciated by the City of Guelph. I have no doubt that President Vaccarino will strengthen the bonds between us. In fact, he already has. His gesture in raising the Griffin flag at City Hall for the first time for our new students of our city was well received and appreciated. And there are many ways we continue to work together. Just one example is Guelph's Open Government Plan. This year, the university hosted our very first hackathon working with your students and our data here on the campus. And as a next step, we're partnering together on a Civics Solution Lab, an on-the-ground lab where together the city and the university will create and test new problem-solving models and find solutions to some of our most complex problems here in Guelph. This is tremendously exciting for us with the installation of a new president and with the number of new opportunities that we share on the horizon. President Vaccarino joins a broad and diverse community of leaders. We are all looking forward to working together to continue to build Guelph's strong future. So on behalf of the Corporation of the City of Guelph, its council, its employees, and the community we serve, I am truly honored to extend a very warm and heartfelt welcome to President Vaccarino, his family, and friends. Welcome.
Thank you, Anne, and I overlooked saying that Anne is the Chief Administrative Officer of the City of Guelph. Now please join me in welcoming Dr. Paul Davidson, President of the Association of Universities and Colleges of Canada. Paul?
Mr. Chancellor, students, faculty, alumni, friends of the university, what a great afternoon to be here at Guelph. A day that's filled with inspiration, hope, and promise. And that's why I'm so pleased to bring greetings from the 97 universities and degree-granting colleges who share your passion for discovery, learning, and community service. I particularly want to congratulate the university for its choice of an individual of such remarkable accomplishment and distinction. And with you, pledge our support to President Vaccarino as he exercises his leadership to ensure that this great university can continue to make contributions to Guelph, Canada, and the world. Congratulations and welcome.
Thank you, Dr. Paul Davidson. Now I would like to invite Dr. Donna Wolcott, who is former Associate Vice President Academic for our own university here at Guelph, and now Executive Director of Quality Assurance from the Council of Ontario Universities, to bring greetings. Donna.
Thank you, Well, it's always wonderful to be back in Guelph. It's such a great pleasure that I bring greetings and congratulations to Dr. Franco Vaccarino on behalf of the Council of Ontario Universities. As a Guelph alumnus and a former member of the faculty, it is a special honor for me to be part of the celebrations to welcome Dr. Vaccarino to this new position. As all of us know now, and many of you knew before, Dr. Vaccarino has demonstrated exemplary success in his various academic leadership roles at the University of Toronto. These experiences, coupled with internationally recognized work in mental health, will be of great benefit to the University of Guelph community. I know that you will continue to nurture Guelph's reputation as a forward-thinking university where teaching and learning go hand in glove with research excellence. Guelph is an institution that aims to shape the leaders of tomorrow with a true sense of altruism, justice, and community service. An important role as president is to inspire our students and the university community as they pursue their quest for knowledge and for lifelong learning. And as people get to know you and appreciate your strategic strengths and dedication to the success of your students, your passion will join theirs in Guelph's continued quest for excellence. Today, there are many celebrations and voices sharing their hopes and dreams for a prosperous future. So please be sure to pause long enough to really celebrate your installation and enjoy this wonderful day. Guelph's leadership at the Council of Ontario Universities has, over the years, made a remarkable difference to all of the universities in Ontario. Your colleagues across the sector wish you all the best on this momentous occasion and look forward to continuing our important work together. So on behalf of COU, please accept our warmest congratulations. Congratulations.
Thank you, Donna. It's wonderful to have leaders from the city, the province, and across the country bringing greetings to President Vaccarino on this occasion. We now have greetings from a number of key people here at the University of Guelph. First, I would like to welcome Brandon Gorman, who is president of the University of Guelph Alumni Association. Brandon, please.
Thank you. As a University of Guelph alumnus and president of the University of Guelph Alumni Association, I'm delighted to be here this afternoon and officially welcome Dr. Franco Vaccarino to the University of Guelph family. Dr. Vaccarino, you are pleased to know that we have a vibrant and engaged community of alumni. You're an army of alumni. We'll be backing you as you embark on your leadership journey with the University of Guelph. We are more than 100,000 people strong, living and working in over 140 different countries. Guelph grads are attaining extraordinary achievements worldwide and contributing to their professionals, professions, and communities in remarkable ways. The university is proud to count among its alumni an astronaut, a CFL head coach, a women's hockey gold medalist, federal and provincial politicians, an NFL general manager, and multiple TV personalities. There are doctors, lawyers, biologists, designers, vintners, restaurant owners, animators, researchers, novelists, poets, historians worldwide, all of which we are greatly proud of them for. Each one of these alumni is contributing to a better planet in his or her own unique way. From engineering and health sciences to animal welfare, agricultural, and the fine art, the University of Guelph alumni are making a difference in the lives of people and communities worldwide. The fabric of our alumni is woven with many different threads: excellence, service, philanthropy, commitment, passion, and innovation. It is not surprisingly that the University of Guelph can proudly boast more than 100 alumni that have received the Order of Canada. This honor is one of the highest distinguished service honors for outstanding achievements and merit in the highest degree. The University of Guelph Alumni Association's mission is to sustain and strengthen the University of Guelph. We do this in many ways, most importantly by connecting alumni with their Alumni Matter, From alumni events and award celebrations to communications programs and advocacy events, we are engaging with our alumni and keeping them involved. The UGAA also offers great service and benefits, and as our alumni know, membership does have its privileges. You will often hear alumni talk about what a special place Guelph is. Guelph is more than just a campus and its buildings. There is a strong sense of community here, which has touched each of us in a different way. This is an institution that we are extremely proud of, one that holds a special place in all of our hearts. The UGA has a strong history of partnership and support. When plans for Rozanski Hall were announced, the University of Guelph Alumni Association pledged $500,000 to the project. We then doubled that campaign commitment to $1 million for the Better Planet project in support of the first year seminars, and recently made a pledge, a leadership gift to the University of Guelph Griffin statue that you see at the corner today. Dr. Vaccarino, you can expect to see the same kind of commitment from the UGA in the years ahead. On behalf of the University of Guelph Alumni Association, on all of the University of Guelph alumni, welcome to our family. We are thrilled to have you join the Guelph community. Thank you.
Thank you, Brandon. Now I would like to invite Professor Kelly Meckling to the podium. Kelly is the president of the University of Guelph Faculty Association. Kelly?
Good afternoon. I think they had me trapped back there to try to keep me from speaking, but I'm here anyway. We're really, really pleased as a member of the university community and as a representative of the University of Guelph Faculty Association to welcome Dr. Vaccarino to our midst. It has been really wonderful getting to know him. We were introduced to him as an association early in the summer. He came and had lunch with us, and we got to know him both personally and a little bit more professionally. As many of you are aware, the University of Guelph has been going through a number of big bumps and hurdles over the last couple of years, and particularly in the last few months. There have been ongoing negotiations with many staff and other working groups on campus. And one of the great things that Dr. Vaccarino has been able to do in his early days here is to settle a number of agreements that were under intense discussion. And so I'm very pleased in particular that yesterday we were able to reach a tentative settlement with the university administration, which brings to close a lot of ongoing things that have been tumultuous for us. Dr. Vaccarino has presented to us, and we are really excited about working with him to develop a vision for the future of the University of Guelph. He comes with lots of great ideas, but he also has a very open mind to inputs from all of the university community. Faculty, veterinarians, and librarians at the University of Guelph are very committed to this institution. We consider ourselves an intimate and integral part of the university community, and we're really looking forward to working together with Dr. Vaccarino to continue to make Guelph the place that alumni and others want to come back to, and to continue to produce exceptional students, research, and service activities, both within the Guelph community and in the world at large. So thank you and welcome.
Thank you, Kelly. President Vaccarino, I'd like to now welcome Janet Kaufman, President of the University of Guelph Retirees Association. Janet?
It's an honor for me to represent 2,000 retired staff and faculty of the university today as we celebrate the installation of a new president at the University of Guelph. On behalf of the University of Guelph Retirees Association, I want to extend a very warm welcome not only to President Vaccarino, but to his family, and to wish him success as he embarks on leading this institution into its next 50 years. As retired employees of the institution, We may not be playing a vital role in the day-to-day life of the institution anymore, but we do maintain a lively interest in what is happening. And I'm confident in saying on behalf of our membership that we believe the university will continue to flourish under your leadership. Now, one of the things that retirees may be prone to do in light of that interest that they maintain is to provide well-meaning but unsolicited advice from time to time. And I'm quite certain and confident that President Vaccarino will not only listen but take that advice as it's needed and warranted. I'm going to offer just a little bit of advice of my own, if I may, and I will only do this once, only today, I promise. I hope that as your time here goes on and as you spend your years here at Guelph, you will learn to appreciate and perhaps accept the words of a Scottish author and the creator of Peter Pan. And in his words, nothing is ever work if you'd rather not be doing something else.
Thank you, Janet. Please join me now in welcoming Sarah Whalen from the United Steelworkers Association, who brings greetings to President Vaccarino on behalf of all University of Guelph staff groups.
On behalf of the staff at the University of Guelph, I want to take this opportunity to welcome you to our beautiful campus. I hope that your first weeks are going well and that you're settling comfortably into your new position and home. Imagine a perfect summer morning with racing shells slicing through the river while the coxswain calls out cadence, a picture of common goals and cooperation. In effect, a community working together. The University of Guelph has always been, in many ways, a small community. That feeling of community was an important part of what formed the cultural environment that made the University of Guelph a positive experience for everyone, students and workers alike. We look forward to the common goals and collaboration that can reignite that positive feeling of community. We become hopeful when reading that you were effective at raising spirits and morale at the U of T Scarborough and creating an atmosphere of optimism about the potential of that campus. We applaud you for your commitment to pay close attention to the campus, community interactions. Noticing and understanding the interactions throughout the campus community are the first steps in creating a better campus and community. These are all very important concepts to the staff here. You will find the University of Guelph has some of the most dedicated and committed workers that you will ever run across. This place is important to us as workers, as parents, as alumni, as students, and as community members. Excitement is generated by your view that the vision for this institution should be a shared vision. We look forward to your tenure as president and hope to develop a close working relationship with you so that we can work together toward a bright future for the campus and community. Once again, I would like to convey my sincerest greetings on this occasion.
Thank you, Sarah. Please join me in welcoming Sonali Menezes, External Affairs Commissioner with the University of Guelph, who brings a message on behalf of the Central Student Association. Sonali.
I'm going to bring down this a little bit. Thank you so much. I just want to say how happy I am to see the whole Guelph community here together to greet you, Mr. Vaccarino. Just to illustrate, Sarah, from the United Steelworkers Union, we were downstairs and I got my robe and it was way too big. It'd run out of the smalls. And she said, hey, why don't you just take mine and we'll do a little swap. I'm wearing heels. And we did that. And I'm so happy that you can enter into this sort of community because it's really one that students are really, really proud of. I also bring greetings from QP, Local 1334, the labor union. Maryland. They're outside having a carnival right now to raise money for the United Way and are not able to be here. So greetings from them as well. The first time I met Mr. Vaccarino was on move-in day at the university, so really exciting and hectic time. And we were all sort of welcoming students, and we were doing in little loops, the Central Student Association. We were speaking to students right after Mr. Vaccarino was. And it just thrilled us to meet someone who was so down to earth. He was wearing jeans, he was wearing his University of Guelph shirt, and spoke to us about art, and we were talking about some local music, and it was so great to see him just sort of be present for students. And we've got so much to be proud of right now at the university. We've got 50 years under our belt, and students are really, really excited to continue to work with Mr. Vaccarino to ensure that this university can continue to be a place that we're proud of, can continue to be one of the top comprehensive universities in the country. We are in a critical time, and we are excited to see the solutions implemented at the university to ensure that this is a community that all community members can still be proud of. So thank you so much, and welcome to the university.
Thank you, Sonali. Thank you to all of the speakers so far. President Vaccarino, we have a number of representatives from universities across Canada. I'm going to call the names of the representatives, and the representatives, I'll ask you to stand as your name is read, and please remain standing until I have read all of the names of the representatives. From McGill University, Byron Beeler. For University of Toronto, Judith Wolfson. For Queen's University, Kate Revington. For Huron University College, Elaine Duncanson. For Wilfrid Laurier University, Cynthia Camaccio. For Memorial University, Mark Outerbridge. For Carleton University, Dr. Richard Reed. And for Royal Roads University, David Alloway. Thank you, you may be seated.
Thank you.
President Vaccarino will now give his installation address.
Mr. Chancellor, members of the board, Chair of our Board of Governors, Dick Freeborough, Presidents Weingart and Summerlee, fellows of the university, honorary degree recipients, members of the legislature, Minister of Parliament, Frank Valadiote, Madam Minister Sandals, Minister of Provincial Parliament, Ted Arnott, Consul General Mishra from India, past and current presidents of universities and colleges, alumni, retirees, faculty, staff and students from both the University of Guelph and the University of Toronto and other sister universities in Canada, friends and my family. It is a great honor and privilege to serve as our university's new president and vice chancellor. You know, I love orientation week on campus. It's a time of excitement and a time of anxiety, a time of curiosity, but a time of hesitation. For our students, it's a new beginning. As I watched students settling in and adapting to their new academic home, it became clear that how our students experience and how they understand our university and its values has a huge impact on how they will adapt. It further occurred to me that as a university, as an institution, how we experience and understand the impact of the outside world on us and how we understand our impact on one another shapes how we, on a macro level, move forward. So today, let's take the opportunity to reflect upon three impacts: the impact of the world on us, the impact we can have on ourselves and on each other, and the impact that we can have on the world. Now, I'm an optimist by nature, and in many ways we are living through what might be remembered as one of the most exciting and important periods throughout history. The world today is marked by unprecedented dynamicity, incredible advances in life sciences and physical sciences, in information and communications technology, in the sheer volume of discovery and knowledge. And through all this change, advances in the social sciences, the arts, and the humanities test our belief systems. They challenge our constructs against new and evolving social contexts. And by doing so, offer new information that helps us adapt to these changing realities. We're also witnessing disciplines and subject matter that had been isolated coming together in fresh and exciting ways, like music and computer technology, healthcare and robotic engineering, manufacturing and agriculture. The interconnectedness of our world today makes knowledge more accessible and abundant. This is accelerating discovery and new learning faster than many of us can even catch up to. As a result, the half-life of information, or even knowledge, is strikingly short. Our realities are more transient. So while the impact on society is exciting and energizing, the complexity can be overwhelming, sometimes even paralyzing. Not only are we witnessing unprecedented complexity due to new heights in access, in choice and competition, we are also facing unparalleled uncertainty. On the one hand, there is incredible choice and opportunity. On the other hand, there is massive change and uncertainty. On a personal level, to quote Dickens, it can truly be the best of times and the worst of times. So what are the attributes of humans that will allow us not only to survive, but to thrive in such dynamic times? They include the ability as individuals and as a university for us to adapt and to readapt in a healthy way to uncertainty and change. And by adaptation, I don't mean passive habituation. I'm referring to the act of very deliberately, very consciously redefining ourselves based on what is going on around us. When faced with change, all organisms adapt. Sometimes they adapt in healthy ways, and sometimes they adapt in less than healthy ways. Think back over 600 years ago to the time of Christopher Columbus. The popular mythology was that the world was flat and that if you were to take to the ocean by boat and keep on going, you would literally fall off the earth. Those adhering to this view were adapting. They were adapting by holding on even more firmly to their belief in a flat earth. But there was another emerging view, a view informed by the thoughtful and scholarly analysis of the time, that the earth was actually round. That view reflected a very different sort of adaptation to the uncertainty, a way that incorporates thoughtful perspective taking. So the truth is that Christopher Columbus didn't believe that he would drop off the edge of the earth. Yes, his point of view was inherently optimistic, fueled by the hope that defines the best of human beings, but his beliefs were also informed by thoughtful and disciplined analysis. The opportunity for us is to adapt and change in healthy ways, to undertake thoughtful analysis that will help uncover the upside of uncertainty, as Columbus did. This provides hope, provides inspiration and discovery. It's about taking uncertainty and turning it into something special. Within the context of today's world, an important part of our mission as a university is to provide an environment of broad perspectives and analysis, and the opportunity for people to adapt in healthy ways to a changing world, as we ourselves organizationally adapt and change in healthy and positive ways. How do we adapt to make the most of new realities? What impact can we as a university have internally on our own adaptation and on our next generation of students? Well, on a macro level, Ontario's post-secondary system should seek to adapt in a healthy way to changes that surround us. We can also shape change. We can be leaders in that regard here at the University of Guelph. And on a micro level, we must shape our culture, continue to refine our learning methods, and create environments that enable individual learners and researchers to adapt to change in healthy ways. Now, a duality exists between our timeless values and the need for constant evolution. In pursuit of healthy adaptation, we must never compromise what makes Guelph so unique. Our integrity, our team and community spirit, characterized by the willingness to look out for our neighbors and to work together towards common goals, and demonstrated through our volunteer work across this beautiful city of Guelph and right around the world. How and what we choose to explore will always be grounded in and guided by these timeless values that we have held for 150 years. People have always looked for meaning and belonging, seeking a sense of personal identity and direction. With today's pace of change and related uncertainties, this is more important than ever, because the rules of engagement within our social contracts that used to exist are changing and evolving. That creates uncertainty. We have places in our society that help address uncertainty and that provide people hope for the future by confronting ambiguity and by bringing clarity, by providing the tools to successfully navigate through the complexities and dynamics of a modern society. Those places are universities. Let our university provide people with hope and clarity. Let us instill an ability to adapt and indeed to thrive within a more ambiguous and ever-changing environment. Let us ensure that the physical environment and campus experience created at our university results in meaningful learning, world-renowned breakthroughs, and personal growth. And let us also remember that universities provide a home for students during a key transition in their own personal journeys, when they are undergoing a key transformation in their own development. Universities provide important environments, environments that enhance learning and incubate new ideas by facilitating meaningful human interaction and productive collaboration. The debate and discussion encouraged by university environments go beyond technical skill. It is in these physical spaces where students develop the analytical and the soft skills that will serve them well through each and every job they might have. Powerful learning experiences are inextricably linked to the physical and social environments in which they occur. That's because physical spaces enrich experiences, so they are remembered in a way that deepens understanding. Places exist within us, and they are with us forever. There are those who would suggest that distance learning can replace all this. I believe that the relationship between online learning and traditional university settings is a false dichotomy. The sanctuary offered by a great university like ours should not be threatened by technology or by an ever-changing world. Rather, ours becomes an even more critical place where the best of technology, direct human interaction, and physical spaces manifest themselves at their very best. By enhancing the power of place through technology and through connectivity, we help advance the healthy adaptation of our students, of one another, and of the world around us. Another important theme within the post-secondary sector over the past number of years has been job readiness. We've all heard that term used. Understandably, in these times of economic uncertainty, students and learners want at least a modicum of certainty that the programs they enter will yield rewarding and paid employment opportunities upon their completion. But in my view, the definition of job readiness has shifted. That's because the shelf life of new and emerging knowledge is shorter than ever. You know, many of our last names relate to the occupations that our ancestors passed down to their children and grandchildren. Vaccarino, for example. Anyone want to take a guess what that means? Well, it roughly translates into cowherder in Italian. Now, anyone who knows me would know that I would not make a very good cowherder. Gone are the days when generation upon generation within families have the same careers. Gone are the days where an individual has just one career. Today, many individuals have multiple careers in their lifetimes, and in many professions and careers, the subject matter itself is in constant evolution. There are few jobs today where the knowledge and skills necessary for getting hired will still be sufficient in future years. That's why our opportunity is to evolve how and what we teach. Beyond teaching subject matter strictly and toward the process of learning, learning to learn, adaptation and creativity. Successful graduates of tomorrow will blend knowledge, mixing and matching ideas from separate disciplines. They will have the creative skills to apply the knowledge in innovative, exciting, and new and different ways. They will be the new professionals, multidisciplinary, lifelong learners. So how can we stay ahead of the curve? How can we attract, train, and launch these new professionals? How do we support them within our faculty, staff, and community cultures? Well, in part, by emphasizing disciplinary breadth and depth, by systematically and thoughtfully helping our students understand the component parts of critical thinking and analysis and how they work together, by teaching and exercising mental nimbleness, helping people to learn how to connect the dots, and by understanding and teaching innovation 2.0. Innovation is no longer a differentiator. It's become the price of entry. If you were to review the values of the top 20 universities in Canada, mark my word, almost all of them, probably all of them, would claim innovation as a core value. We need to understand innovation as an ongoing creative process. Innovative thinking is quickly becoming a baseline expectation within a society in which the shelf life of new information is shortening at an unprecedented pace. A pace at which it is not uncommon for information learned in first year to be outdated by the final year of studies. Our ability to cycle rapidly from existing knowledge to new and emerging knowledge will be dependent on our critical analysis skills. Skills that combine with an emphasis on creativity will drive innovative solutions to the issues of the day. We will need to be deliberate and precise in articulating the learning outcomes necessary to provide these cross-cutting and transferable analytical and cognitive skills. And we will need to ensure that employers understand the value add of these skills, the value add of a university experience. Helping students gain more of the kinds of problem-solving skills and cognitive flexibility that they need to get good jobs and then to have a major impact once they land those jobs. That's good for the students, it's good for their employers, it's good for our economy, and it's good for our society. Our world needs more of the University of Guelph. It needs more of what we stand for. It needs more of our knowledge in action as we take breakthrough ideas and bring them to life in powerful and important ways that helps change people's lives. And it needs more of our ethos and culture. It is not sufficient to achieve great breakthroughs and not show the world how to make the most of our newfound solutions to problems. We have a solemn responsibility to apply the breakthroughs and fresh thinking that are happening within Guelph's classrooms and labs and within our student life experiences in ways that enhance our communities and our world. The conclusions we must draw must be ambitious. We must go beyond simply articulating the what and do more than deducing the so what. We must lead the discussion of the now what, turning our research breakthroughs, our new and emerging knowledge into action, seeing our ideas come into common practice and have an impact. Here's the good news. At the University of Guelph, we are already skilled at bringing research and scholarship to life. Understanding how the process of musical improvisation can be linked to community building and creating social change. Inventing DNA barcoding to identify different species around the planet. Helping our Arctic communities adapt socially to changes in their local climates. Producing omega-3 eggs and milk. Using farm crops to develop new recyclable materials for car parts. Creating the world's first shipping fever vaccine. Graduating commerce students who will be leaders in sustainability and green business. And discovering water on Mars. At Guelph, we apparently bring research to life, not just locally and globally, but on other planets too. Our achievements are helping to change the world, and they will continue to change the world over the next 50 years and beyond. The spirit of innovation is alive and well here in this region. The strength we have through partnerships with local organizations and the land around us enables a diversity of perspective that fuels innovation. For example, the University of Guelph has recently partnered with Club Coffee to produce the first ever 100% compostable single-serve coffee and teapots using plant-based resin. That's exciting, that's impact, that's what shaping a better world is all about. Let the University of Guelph be known for creating and nurturing thinkers who recognize and who act on their responsibility to use their education to promote well-being. Our university has so many tremendous strengths. The time is right to build upon it and unleash those strengths. Not simply for the sake of further recognition, but because we have the opportunity and responsibility to improve the lives of individuals, our communities, and the world around us. There's an increasing discussion about the nature of post-secondary education, and there's a growing call for reforming the entire system. Let us not only be part of that conversation, but let us lead this conversation and bring our experience, our point of view, and our perspective to bear. As today's torchbearers for the University of Guelph, we all have an important responsibility. one that doesn't just respond to the world around us, but that helps change the thinking, discourse, and direction of society. One that recognizes and emphasizes the importance of the University of Guelph on the global stage. That's important, that's exciting, so let us take what's best about the University of Guelph and share it with the world. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. I'd like to take a moment here to recognize my family who are here with me today. It's wonderful to have my aunt and uncle, Catherine and Dominic, where are you? There we are, from here from the States, as well as a number of my cousins who have come from New York, New Jersey, and Carolina with me here today. Also have a number of Canadian cousins here. It's kind of like a big Italian wedding here. By the way, all my cousins are named Tony, so it's very easy to... And my brother. My brother Anthony and his partner Julie and my wonderful nieces Sophie and Isabel are here with us, and delighted that they could join us. I'd also like to give a shout out to our children, Oriana and Alicia, who are both with me today. They keep me on my toes, still take me to rock concerts, inspire me, keep me young, and remind me that the future indeed looks bright. My mother is also here, Alfonsina Vaccarino. And I want to welcome my mom. From the day I actually tried to explain to her what kind of doctor I was actually becoming, she's always been my biggest fan. She's also celebrating her 81st birthday next week with plenty of energy to spare. So happy birthday, mom. Just stand up and say hi to people. Stand up. A shout out to my dad as well. My dad passed on a few years ago, but I know he's here in spirit, and probably actually still trying to figure out exactly what it is that I do for a living. So, finally, to my wife, Cosmina, we celebrated our 32nd anniversary a couple of weeks ago. 32 great years, and it's been an exhilarating and beautiful journey. A journey that started in 1980 at McGill when I first noticed Cosmina in our neurochemistry of behavior class. Her English wasn't great at the time, but we figured it out. It's a good story for another time. Cosmina, thanks for being here to share all of this, and look forward to our journey over the next 32 years. Thank you again to all. Thank you.
Well, I'd like to thank the new president for his remarks and for the inspiration in the leadership forward. As the choir sings the final musical selection, the platform party will rise and depart from the stage, led by the Beatle. They will proceed down the aisle, followed by members of the procession seated in the audience. Dr. Vaccarino and his family will form a receiving line in front of War Memorial Hall to greet you all as you leave the building. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.